And then Anthony was telling me how on our first day, as we were kind of trying to work out the twerks, he was trying to go around to the lineup and talk to people and interact with them. And he gets to one guy and he's like, yeah, I'll get 2 beers, please. And Anthony's like, wouldn't it be great if we could serve alcohol to these people? They would be so much happier in line. I think it was interesting because I think with a lot of people, it was in general with what we're going through with COVID, it was about, you know, taking baby steps. And that's exactly what we did, right? We started with the curbside and figured that out. And then we tried to do open the market and curbside, and that was very hard. And then we opened the market and we did it more of a deli style, kind of point at what you want. And we saw how that went through and we got feedback. And then the next baby step was opening the market and figuring it out. And I think, you know, I think that worked well for us because it gave us time to, you know, get comfortable with each of the stages in terms of how we were going to proceed, what safety precautions we had to do, what worked well, what didn't work well. You know, our first day open, you know, of course it rained, right? And it was like we didn't have coverings for people that were waiting in line to get in. So, you know, each day we made things better, or we tried to make things better and improve things, both from a servicing component and from a safety perspective. So that's the one takeaway I think we've gotten, is that we were good at making sure that we took the steps slowly and we gathered information and we observed and then we proceeded.
I think I'm so glad that we're open. We can finally display and merchandise our product the way it was made to be. And now people are actually shopping and they can see better. And we're actually, our sales are going back to normal, because before it wasn't really working. I know a lot of people liked it, but it wasn't good. There was people who had the pointed stuff. It was very hard to keep the stuff in line and keep it even looking nice. People like to buy with their eyes. And so when they see nice stuff the way we set it up, they buy it. And you know what brings them back is because we have good tasting stuff. So that's what brings them back. But the people buy with their eyes. 90% of the time, they buy with their eyes. You know, the only thing they don't buy with their eyes is milk and eggs. And even the eggs, our eggs, people come back because of the taste of our eggs. They're good eggs. I'm so happy we're open.
I think this will be our setup till the end of the season at this point. And depending on next year, I think this is how we'll open the market next year. The process works. It allows customers the opportunity to shop in a non-congested area. It does mean that there's a lineup to get in, but in previous years there was a lineup once you were in. So, you know, it's kind of a balancing act right now, but I feel that it allows us to service customers and give them the time they need to shop and purchase what they would like.
I am very excited. I hope it gets better every day. I'm comfortable. People don't get close to us. I'm able to do my job, and most of all the customers are very happy. I can see that they like it. That makes me happy. Sometimes they're a little bit tired waiting the line, but it's worth it, they say, and it's all okay. We gotta do what we gotta do.
We opened originally with you know, the service counter style, and then we changed it to open market. So what we saw happening with the service counter style was it was difficult to merchandise everything we had. So people were constantly missing items that we had, and we were getting a lot of that feedback. But at the same time, we saw that all the customers coming in were following the rules. So everybody was wearing a mask, everybody was sanitizing their hands. We had very, very few issues in terms of you know, the protocols that we had put in place. So we thought it would be safe that, you know, if everyone's wearing a mask and everybody's sanitizing their hands and we're sanitizing shopping carts after every use, then, you know, why not let people come in and look at the produce that they're buying and see the full array of what we have, right? So that's what we're doing now, and it's working well. It's working well. I mean, it's still, you know, it still hurts that we have to restrict the number of people, but it is what it is. You know, it's shopping in 2020. That's how it is. Like, we have a certain capacity due to the size of the market, and and we can only let so many people in at a time, right? So some people love it, some people love that they can come in and, you know, still listen to the music. You can hear the music, right? And enjoy the experience of looking at the produce and picking it up and that kind of thing. And then we have people that want curbside back, right? So, and that's the story of this year, right? Like, people's attitude and opinions of the entire situation is very different. And I'm seeing that in the feedback. So, but it's been mostly positive for the way we've set it up. I think everyone's appreciating the protocols that we've put in place. Everyone feels safe coming in. You know, like, one thing that people aren't enjoying, and I'm not a fan of it myself, is waiting in line. I don't know anybody that enjoys waiting in line. But, you know, I know that I've had to go into stores recently, and I've had to wait in line. So I know the feeling of having to wait for something that you need, but at the same time, it's protocols that we have to put in place. But that's been the majority of the negative feedback has been about waiting in line, or the line being too long, or whatnot. But the positive feedback has been that now I can see the full array of the product that you have, and I'm enjoying the experience again. I love seeing all the product. I love picking out what I'm gonna get, and so on.
It's certainly a great feeling to be able to interact with customers. The customers can walk freely into the market again, and they can select what they like. They can see what we offer, especially from the farm. Growing here is what we're all about, homegrown, and we have a lot of good stuff. So, like, the cucumbers are in, the tomatoes are coming in nice. So it's great. People want to see it, they want to touch it, of course. But still, I think people want to move freely. That's what it's all about. I have to say, for anything, we're more on top. We're more cautious and aware of the customers, and so too the customers are being respectful, staying the distance. They know the protocols, everything. We have signs posted throughout the building, so, you know, it's I think we're doing well with it as a whole, as a company. They're really on top of it, and that's nice to see. We haven't changed anything there. We haven't changed the protocols. The protocols are in place for everybody, for everybody's safety.
So one thing that we've done is, in order to keep the proper counts of how many people are in the market, we've actually had to close off to this area that we're currently in, right? And so we've kept, like, the bulk sales completely separate from the market sales. And to be honest, that system is working much better than when we had the entire flow open. It seems to keep things more organized, and I'm enjoying that. So even when the pandemic is done and we no longer have to count how many people are inside the market, I think this is here to stay. Like, we're controlling, you know, we're almost operating it, like, separately. It's definitely working, so that's one thing. And even honestly, as much as I hate controlling the flow into the market, I think it actually helps people who are shopping in the market see what's in the market better when there's less people in there. So, you know, we're only letting in 12 to 15 groups, 12 to 15 customers at a time. Those 12 to 15 customers at a time have the ability to shop the entire store. Whereas, you know, when we were very busy and we had like 50, 60 people in there, it was very crowded and people weren't able to shop properly. We weren't even able to fill the market properly, right? When it was very crowded. So, you know, although like I said before, I hate lines, but at the same time, it does help with people's ability to shop, right? Because they have more space, and we have more space to fill and keep things neat and tidy and keep things clean. So, yeah.
I would say about 90 to 95% of the customers who are reaching out to us have been fantastic. Patient, supportive, understanding, completely embracing the fact that this is new for us and we're trying to figure it out. And I think those are the customers, you know, we feel bad. We feel bad because we want to service everybody and we want to make everybody happy and we want to do everything and we don't want people to wait. And, you know, when we see customers doing that, we feel this this pressure. Not that anybody's putting it on us, but we feel it. And to get people voluntarily saying, you guys are doing a great job and the process works and I don't mind waiting for good food and supporting local and thank you for everything you've done and for, you know, being there. It kind of is the reassurance that you need to do better and know that, you know, people are supporting you and during this time of uncertainty. So that's been a lot of the great stuff. Obviously there's some people that, you know, miss curbside and we feel really bad about that. But the truth of the matter is we just don't have the space and staffing capacity to run both. We talk about it all the time to see if we can find a solution. It's not completely off the table, but we can't do everything all at once. We need to, same way with opening, we need to do it in stages, and we hope to bring curbside back at some point if we can figure it out. So, but overall, I want to say a big thank you to all of our customers because they've been phenomenal. They've been truly, the feedback has been great and it keeps us going. So thanks.
I don't know, 2020 is the year of crazy, right? So like, I feel like every day is a new kind of crazy. But you know, overall, it's one day at a time, you know, and it is what it is. We've already changed. We've been open for what, 3 weeks? About that, and we've changed the system about 3 or 4 times. But it is what it is. I think, you know, trying to figure out things in this kind of environment, in this kind of world, it's gonna take time. And I, you know, obviously I feel the pressure of it all, but you know, it's fine. It's all manageable. Every day happens, every day comes and goes, and it's all good.
So if someone would have told me last year what 2020 would have been like, I would have never have believed them. 2020 has been a year filled with unexpected twists and turns, truly an emotional roller coaster with stresses coming from places you never expected and dealing with things that you've never even imagined that you would need to deal with. It is without question that this will be one of the years that we continue to talk about for years to come about how challenging 2020 was on our industry in particular and our market. But we will remember 2020 as a year where we've come together as a family, as a farm, and as a community, supporting one another, showing our patience, and being there during this tough time that we didn't see coming. Over the course of this season, we've tried our best to share our experiences with our customers as we'd learn to adapt to this new world that we're in by the way we farm, the way we manage our operations, and the safety measures that we've had to put in place to ensure that we're doing the best that we can to keep everyone safe. And on that note, I'd like to thank you for your continued patience as we employ new policies, learn new things, implement new procedures, and try to bring you the best that we have to offer. We are working hard to keep our market employees, farmers, and customers safe and happy at all times, while continuing to provide the same high quality produce that we're so proud of growing for our community. For every supportive comment, direct message, cheerful interaction at the market, we appreciate you and we thank you, because those are the comments that keep us going and make us want to do better and work harder and service you each and every day. We hope that next year is a much better year and we can just look back at this year and think we got through it, and that's our goal. So thank you for supporting us and being patient with us.